everybody. In today's lecture, we'll see the basic construction, very basic construction of a transformer. Now, to start with, we must recall the quotation of William Stanley, rightly said, transformer is a heart of alternating current system. There are two scientists, one is Joseph Henry and Michael Faraday. They discovered a property called induction, which we know already. Now, we know flux equal to MMF, magnetomotive force, by reluctance. We know this basic equation. We know reluctance is equal to L by mu A. Now, N is number of turns in the coil, I is current flowing through the coil, L is length of magnetic path, A is cross-sectional area of that path, mu is permeability of the magnetic material. Now, we should recall the most important law in electrical engineering, that is Faraday's law. If you read the first law, it says any relativity between a conductor and the flux will cause an EMF to induce. That's what first law says. Second law says the magnitude of induced EMF is proportional to the rate of change of magnetic flux linked. So these two are very much important for transformer principle. Now, to start with, let's take these points as well as flux as well as reluctance, these equations in our mind. Let's go further. We have a coil which is carrying some alternating current IAC. Now, next to this, I'm having another coil. We just have another coil which is not connected to any supply, just coil is present there. Now, as I supplied this with some alternating current, the flux which is coming out of this is also alternating. So flux is decreasing, increasing, decreasing, increasing, like this. Now, this alternating flux is linking with this coil as well as this coil. So according to Faraday's law, magnetic flux is linking with a conductor. This is also one conductor, this is also a conductor. So each and everything is one conductor. Each and everything here also one conductor. So as this flux is linking with all the conductors, there is some EMF induced in all these conductors. Now, if you want to name the induced EMF in this conductor, is called as self-induced EMF, because EMF induced in these conductors or in these turns is because of its own flux. Hence, it is called as self-induced EMF. The EMF induced in this conductor or in these turns, we call it as mutual induced EMF. Now, if you just recall, we know flux is inversely proportional to the reluctance. Now, to increase the amount of flux for the same amount of MMF, we should reduce the reluctance. To reduce the reluctance, we'll insert an iron core here. We're inserting an iron core. Now, this will increase the permittivity of the magnetic path, which means reluctance is reduced. Okay. Now, let's take the same core here, same core form, what we had before. Now, as we know, flux is now passing like this, as well as like this. So these also a flux path, these also a flux path. Now by inserting an iron core here, we have reduced the reluctance of this path, this length. So for further reduction of reluctance, from in here also, we'll keep an iron core, you can see there. So now, complete flux path that this path is having, less reluctance. Now, we know reluctance is equal to L by mu A. It depends on the permittivity of the material. I've chosen a good material. It depends on the area of cross section, and also it depends on the length. Length is more, then reluctance is more, and hence flux is less. So what if I change the same construction to a different configuration? Let's break this into different parts. I have broken this into different parts. Let's rearrange them in another configuration. Let's put these. Now with this configuration, I have a closed path which is of less length than this, and I could save this material also. So this is one form of transformer which is called as core type transformer. So these are basic construction of a transformer. Now we'll do many modifications on this to increase the magnetic linkage even further, like shell type and different types of windings. So it's all we'll see in the further classes. Thanks for watching the video. If you want us to discuss any topic in electrical engineering, please write to us through comment section below. And please subscribe to our channel for more updates. Thank you.